G'day, I'm Justin from Black Opal Direct. Well, today we're going to cut a barrel cut. Well, I have this magnificent piece of colour and it has every colour in it. There's a lot of orange and red, but it's quite a weird shape. And I do have to cull some of the shape because of the chips and sand spots it's got. And also, I don't think it needs to have extra bits hanging off the side. So what I've decided to do today is cut a very unconventional shape, which is called a barrel shape. And what it is it's got two flat sides and a rounded edge, just like a barrel. And that kind of a shape can be really nice in a ring. So let's go through the process of cutting this magnificent stone into a barrel. So for some of you out there that aren't very practiced at doing shapes that you're not used to, the best way to make a shape on a stone is to draw the shape on first. And then you've got an outline or a guide to help you be able to figure out, am I grinding too much away or am I not? And that way, when you draw it on there, you get the maximum size of the stone. So I'm going to do that now and do a bit of a drawing and see how it comes up. So while I'm cutting this stone, I'm really trying to save on weight. And if I can get at least this many carats out, I'll be so happy. But if I get this many carats out, I'll be ecstatic.
All right. So as you can see, I've drawn on there, but that's just an outline really. I am going to make it slightly wider than that drawing. It just gives me a little bit of a guide.
The preform is probably the most important part of the process, where you really actually get to see what you're cutting out. It's really important to even out that back before you put it on a dop stick, so that then you know that the top of the stone is even when the bottom's hiding in the wax. The final preform adjustments had been done just before I glue it on.
Finely shaped.
Starting out with a good setting edge is really important, because when the jeweler gets the stone, they need an edge to be able to set the stone into the piece of jewelry. And without that edge, that opal can fall out. The Nova wheels I have on here I really should have changed. I have some older ones that are smoother, and these wheels really cut into a good gemstone too much, so I just had to be a little careful. Taking a gemstone off the stick like this can be dangerous and you can chip the stone. So I really advise you to put it in the freezer first. I promise you it won't hurt the stone and the wax becomes brittle, so you can just break it off. Right, so the big test is here. What does this opal weigh? Drum roll. Can you see that? Can you see that? I was hoping for around the 2, and I've just cracked 3.01 carats. Yes! I am so happy. So this beautiful gem, just making 3.01 carats, I think it's valued at around about 2,000 a carat, which makes it a $6,000 gem. And what a perfect shape, gem, and size for a masculine ring. A really, really nice stone. I think it would be awesome. Well, that's it for this week. If you're wondering why I'm missing a couple of videos here and there, this is Tucson time, when the Tucson Gem Show is happening. And in 2 weeks' time, we will be over there in Tucson, meeting as many of you as possible. Because I love to meet the people that I talk to, because I'm talking to you, but not many people get to talk back. You get to comment back, and I love your comments. I really appreciate them. But I don't get to see you face to face, and this is my opportunity to actually meet you, and that makes me excited. So, I can feel it.